Assalamu alaikum. Just one more word I want to say. As you all know, F5, the management of this is not purely just doing angioplasty. I know that diabetes is a multi-system process. So we are only a small part. You are really the big part. The big part of looking after the sugar, the statins, the well care, the health of the foot, the wound care, and so on. So we really thank you for your work. I just want to give you a very quick brief about what we do in interventional radiology in our hospital. So we have several areas that we are focusing on. Liver cancer program is a very big program. It's a priority for the hospital. Diabetic foot, that's why we're here. Vascular anomaly program. We'll look at it. There are highly skilled procedures. There are not many of them, but really very difficult procedures. And there are high flow procedures, simple, but a very large number of them, and research. So last year, we've done about 8,000 cases. We've been accepting increasingly large numbers. Every year, we are accepting more patients, thanks to you. You are the ones who are referring, and you, and the bulk of those patients have been lower limb angioplasty, and you can see 2015 and 16, and alhamdulillah, we are getting good results, at least angiographically. And the reason we wanted to focus on this, if you notice, amongst the world, Saudi Arabia is really probably the highest country that has diabetes and therefore complications of diabetes. For the hospital, what is really making the hospital accept what we are doing is that all our procedures are done as outpatients. They come in the morning, we do the procedure a few hours, and they go home. Last year, 2016, we've done about 500 angioplasties. And this is the difference. I think this is a patient with Dr. Al-Aqda, right? And this is the difference between the foot before angioplasty and after angioplasty. What we're trying to say is that hopefully this will aid in this multidisciplinary team in improving the patient's care. We've been doing outreach visits to the different hospitals. Last year wasn't very good, but this year we planned 24 visits, inshallah, 3 workshops. This is the first of the 3 workshops. This work is led by Dr. Fida Aladdin, and I thank him very much. He's done a great job and great effort in organizing the workshop with Saad. Liver cancer is a cancer hospital primarily. And we have a tumor board looking at cancers, mainly at hepatocellular carcinoma. 90% of hepatocellular carcinoma is treated by interventional radiology alone. Okay, and we do a variable procedure, radiofrequency ablation, chemoembolization, and radioembolization. We've done over 1,000 cases so far. And this is a breakdown of radioembolization over the years, and you can see that over the years it's increasing. And this is chemoembolization, and also over the years it's increasing. Some variation because of introduction of some competition between radioembolization and chemoembolization. This is radiofrequency ablation, where you put the needle in the tumor and you burn it. Also, this has been increasing over the years since 2008. The second program, which I look after with a group of surgeons, plastic surgeons, vascular surgeons, dermatologists, and other people. This is the only program looking after those cases. This program was founded by Dr. Shamari, our previous chairman, and then I took over after he left. Now we have about 700 patients in our pool looking after those. And the bulk of these are treated with sclerotherapy. Dr. Shadran is also on the team. We have a neurointerventional radiologist as well. We have experts coming from the US to help us in the most complex cases. and they have been coming since the beginning of the program, 2008. This is Dr. Patricia Barros. This is an AVM in the middle, and this is on the right side, on capillary malformation with hypertrophy. And this is one of the our successes, again, of a combined multidisciplinary team of surgery, radiology, dermatology, and so on, patients with lymphatic malformation at birth, and this is last year, last picture. Okay. There are some highly skilled procedures. The number is not large, but they really need dedicated work and very high skill, doing TIPS, transjugular portohepatic, portosystemic shunt, portal vein recanalization, management of patients who had a liver and kidney transplant when they have complication, recanalization of DVT, thoracic duct embolization, and we work in conjunction with surgeons to do endovascular aneurysm repair. The high flow procedures, about half of our procedures are really small but really high number, and mainly venous access, permanent catheter main lines, dialysis patients, gastrostomy, sarcostomy, gastrogastrostomy, and ultrasound guided intervention, drainage of abscesses, taking biopsies, and so on. And I really want to thank our interventional team, our assistants, our fellows. I forgot to tell you that we have 9 interventional radiologists and 5 fellows in our unit. We have 30 nurses and technologists who are really responsible for making this high volume happen. New techniques. Dr. Chagrin is responsible for the fellowship program. He's now updating really the level of our fellowship. Dr. Amr is updating our database, and he is, inshallah, going to make it even better to try to collect the data better. Transradial intervention, Dr. Chagrin. We hope for the future that we will expand on recanalization of DVT. We are thinking about introducing weight loss procedures, gastric artery embolization, prostate artery embolization, and endovascular management of hemorrhoids. This is one of the papers. Primary investigator is Dr. Alaa Al-Din, looking at drug-eluting balloons below the knee and how it's working in our patients. We are the only center outside Europe who is part of this trial. This is just, no need to go through this, but just telling you that we are doing presentations and research, and I want to thank you very much.